Today I'm working on a 10 by 20 canvas, and I'm going to be doing a swipe. You can see I've got my swipe tools here. I've got a bunch of different colors. I have a ton of them, so I just kind of grab. I think today I'm going to work with mainly the 6-inch one, but we'll see. I've got the others out just in case. 1.5 and then 3/4. I use this one a lot for edges. Seems to work really well. So I'm just going to move these ones out of the way. Well, I'll move them all out of the way, I guess, since I have to coat my canvas. But before I get doing that, I'm going to go over the paints that I'm using. And I've got, let me help put that there. Let's see, I've got Amsterdam Pearl paints. There is white, red, violet, and blue, and I've used these in my last couple of videos, and they're super, super pretty. They start out white, and then they kind of change color, so hopefully that will happen again today. And then my cell activator or swipe color is Payne's Gray from Amsterdam as well. My base coat here is really, really pretty. Let me show you. It's a couple that I mixed together. You can see that there. It's pretty, not super runny, but it drips right off the stick into a mound, and then it quickly disappears. So this color is, hit my canvas there. I've got DecoArt Peacock Pearl. It's Dazzling Metallics. I love this color. And then I added some Phthalo Turquoise from the Fine Touch, and then also Deep Turquoise from Winsor&Newton. Just changed the color a little bit, darkened it just a touch. And also, before I get started, one thing for those of you that are newer to acrylic pouring, it is pretty essential to make sure that your canvas is level. All right, so I'm gonna move my canvas here real quick and show you what I have underneath. And these are my canvas levelers. Now I have them covered with Glad press and seal. It helps keep them clean. I mean, they can be washed in warm soapy water, but this will help, you know, keep them clean a little bit longer. And I'm gonna have to re-level because I just messed that up, but they're super easy. You can adjust them, all right? So make sure that your canvas is level. I'm gonna put that one back down, and then I'm going to take my level real quick and kind of show you. Now, when I put mine under there, I do not put them right at the very end. I put them in just a touch. That way, when the paint drips, it still drips off the canvas and not directly on the canvas leveler. So I'm going to set my leveler right there, and I did pretty good. It's right in the middle of the lines there. The bubble is in there, so we're good to go. You always want to make sure that your canvas is level. You don't want to have a gorgeous painting and then come back a little bit later and it has run off, because that has happened to me before, because I used to always use the push pins, which is, you know, a decent way to start, but you still got a mess, and then, you know, hammer it in. My wrists are a little sore after that. And so anyway, so this is the easiest way for me to make sure that my canvas is level. All right, so I am going to go ahead and get my gloves on, and I'm going to cover my canvas, and I'll be right back. All right, so my canvas is covered, and I'm about ready to go. Before I start putting the paint on, though, what I'm going to do, instead of putting my swipe color right through the middle, I'm actually going to pour it onto this tile and then dip in the paint that way. Only kind of because I don't have a lot of this and it may soak into the paper. And this was just a tile that I had resined years ago. I don't have any plain ones. I've been experimenting a little bit, so I ran out of plain ones. So that one will work just fine. All right, so I'm just just going to go ahead and jump in here and start putting the paint on. And these colors are left over. Again, I made a bunch left over from my last couple paintings, my last couple videos, I mean, and just trying to use them up. These Amsterdam pearl paints are really, really fun. Been having a lot of fun with them. And so again, I'm using these up. Now these are mixed 1 teaspoon of the Amsterdam paint to 3 tablespoons of American Floetrol. And then a little bit of water just to thin. Now these had been thickened up on me the other day when I did my other video, so I did add some water, probably about, I don't know, 8 or 10 drops. So just to get them back to a little bit thinner. So here's this, just the white. Now the other one video, the first video I did using these, the painting turned out like, looked like lightning. It was super, super cool. So if you missed that one, go ahead and check that one out. Super pretty. And then this here is, again, it's my cell activator, and you can see it's pretty runny. It's a little bit more runny than the other colors. And then this one was mixed with Australian Floetrol, and that's just because, you know, I got it last week or 2 weeks ago and finally decided to use it, so I thought I would just mix it up in here. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just pour this, a line of it on here. See that? And then I will take my lovely handy dandy swiper and dip that right in there. And then you guys can see kind of how much I've got there. All right, and here we go. Here we go with the dried photos, and look how pretty that dried, those Amsterdam pearl paints just come through, and I love it. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts, so leave me a comment below. If there's something I didn't cover, you have a question, go ahead and leave that in the comments as well. And if you've gotten anything out of my video today, I would appreciate if you could like my video and subscribe as well, and also share it if you think someone else may enjoy it. Don't forget, my Etsy shop link is in the description, and I've got a bunch more videos that I know you will enjoy as well, and I will catch you in the next one.